The Welcome back to Dead Ice in Space and part one of the Crypt Keeper from the Tales of the Crypt. I'll just go into the model in a minute. First of all, a little public service announcement kind of thing, really. Well, it's not a public service announcement, that's just silly. But just to let you guys know, the HMS Daring has actually been finished and that's sitting on my shelf. I'm currently up to part 8 online at the moment, and that goes up to part 11, so there's another 3 parts that I do need to download for that, and then I can start downloading the HMS Kent videos. And funnily enough, that ship, bar the waterscape work that needs to be done, that kit's finished as well, so it's actually sitting in the resin. The ship's built, figures are on, aircraft's on, everything's been weathered and clear coated, etc. So I'm currently working on the last updates for that particular kit. I don't know, to be fair, how the hell I've got so far ahead of myself in these videos, and that's why at the moment I'm kind of pushing out videos one every sort of like 3 or 4 days, mainly because I'm so far ahead of myself. As I say I really don't know what has happened, really, for me to get that far ahead of myself. It's just crazy. So at the moment, I am going to be releasing the rest of the daring videos. I'll do those once every 3 days, just so people don't get too bored of me uploading videos every day. And then once that's finished, I'll then just start downloading all of the videos for the HMS Kent as well. But in between, I will be doing this fellow. So yeah, that's I just thought I'd let you know what's going on. As I say, I've got no idea how I've managed to get so far ahead of myself. It's a bit weird, but I guess it happens. Plus the fact I'm actually still waiting for the decals to come in as well for the Nebula class, which is really going to be my next big build, I think. Really, that's going to be my next big build. I want to get that sorted. So as I say, I'm just waiting for the decals to come in. I've been told that it's going to take up to 3 months for the parts to come in. I suppose it doesn't help because I've actually ordered the resin aftermarket kit as well for the NX-01 refit as well, 1/350 scale. So they'll both be shipped together. And I've been told that it could take up to 3 to 3.5 months for those to come through. So, I'm just going to pop around and do a few other bits and pieces with the 3D printer, actually, to be fair. I mean, there's a lot of parts that I need to print off for the first sort of major diorama that I'm going to do, which will be done later on this year. I've already got a few models for it. In fact, I've got 1, 2, 3, I've got 4 of the model kits for it, and I just need to get another 4 kits. unfortunately, two of those remaining four that I need are going to be chopped up quite heavily. Anywho, back on with the main reason why we're here, and that is this ugly little fellow. So this was printed from my Anycubic Photon M3 printer, and that was printed layer lines at 0.025. And I did, well, as you can see, it's the grey resin that I'm using for the printer. But just to see the overall detail on him, I just gave him a light coat of the Tamiya fine surface primer in white, because you know normally that does help to bring up all the details on him, and he is a bit of an ugly fellow, really. So that's what he kind of looks like. And that's not too bad, actually, for I don't think, for a 3D printer. In fact, well, this is my first print from a 3D printer, to be honest. But yeah, that's what he looks like, and that's the book. And as you can see there, if we can get that turned the right way around. Whoop. There you go. So, Towels from the Crypt. Yeah, so I'm quite happy, actually, with this this little fellow. I've got a few more little figures and whatnot to print off. I've got, I think, the two... Well, there's three, possibly four, actually, that I'm kind of interested in downloading and sorting and getting done. First one is Ed-209, followed by Robocop. And then I've also got a Duke Nukem statue from the original PlayStation game, entitled Duke Nukem. It was a fun character. So here's another one that I'm going to download and do, and hopefully if I can, I'm going to get the Marshmallow Man, Mr. Stay Puffed, from Ghostbusters. So yeah, I don't know how long this is going to take me to do, to be honest, and I don't know how many screw-ups I'm going to make doing it, but that's all part of the fun of learning. You know, maybe I should have started off with a simpler model like Mr. Stay Puffed the Marshmallow Man, because he's just basically white and I think like a royal blue or navy blue or something like that for his little collar bits, because he is meant to be a sailor after all. So that's him. So I brought these paints. Let's zoom out slightly. There we go. So yeah, these are the paints that I've actually bought to help me with the project. So these are the basic, this is basically the undead painting set. Now I've noticed with looking at pictures, he's got that kind of dried up husky kind of skin that you would associate with a mummy. So he's got more brown in there than anything else. But he also, there is a little bit of pink in him, some in some places, and there's also like a bluish purple kind of colour in some areas as well. And then you've just got like all the fleshy bits that you, I'm going to need to do as maybe, I don't know, a bit like dried jerky or something, I don't know. Sorry if anybody eats jerky out there, I might have put you off. Doesn't put me off, actually, to be fair, I still love jerky. But yeah, these are the paints that I'm going to be using to do him. So hopefully, keep fingers crossed, he might turn out reasonably well. We never know. Again, I don't know how many parts this is going to take. It could take me one part, could take me two parts or three parts. I don't know. I have no idea, to be fair. But I will come back to you once I've got some work done to this wee ugly fellow of mine. So I'll be right back. Well, we've got the first round of painting done. Just waiting for some brown paint. Unfortunately, the paints that I bought was the... let's have a look. The paints that I bought were the Knowles's Marvelous Pigments Undead Paint Set. Unfortunately, though, they didn't have a brown in there for mummified skin, so I've had to buy some paint to actually do that. It's a bit too dark, but it's the only paint that I can find that's on its actual own. So I'll just wait for that to come in, and then I can just put a little bit of white in there just to tone it down quite a bit. And that'll be okay. I've temporarily gone over his hair with some grey paint as well, just to see what it was going to look like more than anything else. But this is what he's looking like at the moment. So we've gone for sort of greys and pinks in there, which from reading or watching, sorry, some how-tos, they always say when you're doing that, you need to start off with the greys and the sort of mid-flesh tones and the kind of purples. So that's how we've done that. To get the darker purple, I basically used the light purple that was in the kit, mixed that in with some of the light blue that they had in the kit, and then just put a dash of black in there just to darken it up a little bit more. And then when I did that, I went back over it again as a wet coat with the base colour that I mixed up as well, which was basically the light violet and also the grey that's on his hair at the moment. So yeah, not too shabby if you ask me, to be honest. I'm kind of liking the way that that's looking. So I just now need to wait for the brown paint to come in, so I can give him that kind of mummified look that he needs. And then once that's done, I can just get on and do the hair properly, and get the book done as well. These eyes actually are quite good, if I'm to be honest, because the eyes actually have a little indentation where the pupil's meant to go. So I won't need to worry about fighting that. All I need to do is just paint the eyes in an off-white colour, or maybe kind of a slightly yellowishy warm white for the iris, for the whites of his eyes. The eyeballs themselves, the iris of the eye for the Crypt Keeper, that's a very light blue. So the blue that you actually get in that kit, I use that and just chuck in a little bit of white just to bring it down a shade or two, and that'll be fine. And then all it'd be is just a case of putting a little dab of black paint in where the indentations are for the pupils. And then of course, obviously, we've got the teeth to do as well. And then we've got some flesh to do as well that are in the wound. So that proved to be fairly interesting. But yeah, not too bad at the moment. Quite happy with the progress on that. So first time I've actually painted a figure myself. So yeah, it's going to be interesting as to where we're going to end up on this. So I will come back to you in update 2, where hopefully we've got the skin sorted out. Well, I've now got the Crypt Keeper finished. I think I spent in total about 3 days on this little man. Again, this is my first attempt really at figure painting, and whether I'm going straight in and painting the undead or the mummified undead was a good call to do that, who knows. But this is what it's looking like. We'll just zoom in a little bit for you so you can get a bit of a better look there. I've basically, the paints, I think I said earlier on, the paints that I used, what's a daisy, were the Dungeon and Dragons Undead paint set. But I did also have to buy a different paint, which was the Game Air in the colour that I needed to. It was a flesh tone that was the closest that I could see, to be honest, into creating like mummified flesh. The first portal call that I did was on this, was to use grey with a little bit of pink mixed into it to give him the kind of you know, dead flesh kind of look that has no blood in it. Then I then used the red that was in there with a little bit of blue and a little bit of black, just to get a kind of purplishy colour, that was then washed on in various places as well. And then the flesh colour was then basically washed over the top of that. And then following that, I just used a little bit of black in the flesh tone with, in some areas, to darken areas up, like in between the ribs and underneath the boob, and sort of under the chin and under the cheeks, etc., you know, and in those kind of areas where you are going to get shadows building up naturally. And then just put a slight wash on with the darker colour, and then came back with the same brown with a little bit of white in there just to lighten it up, and then use that as a highlight for him in the areas where you would naturally get light bouncing off. And I think it came out all right for the first attempt at ever doing a figure. With the hair, again, I just used the grey that came with the Dungeons and Dragons kit, and I painted that on, and then splotched some more out and put a little little bit of black in there to basically get into the hair underneath, where it's going to be slightly darker because, you know, lights can't penetrate it that well. And then in a few areas around the sides. And then I came back with the same grey, but with a little bit of white in it, just to go over some other areas. And then came back again to do the main highlights. And again, I just used more white in that than I did the grey. So it was kind of a off-whitey colour, just to go over the very tops of the hair strands to get those done. It's you can see it in person. I mean, whether that's actually coming out on camera or not, I don't know. I mean, in person you can actually see it. But yeah, it's the hair does look quite good actually. With his little eyeballs and the teeth, I basically used the bleached skull white that was in the kit. So I've done those with the teeth as well. Now, normally you would think, right, okay, well, he should have yellowed teeth or something like that. But if you actually look at the TV program, his teeth are as white as anything. And then with the eyes, I basically used the bleached skull. And then I used the blue that was in the same kit as well, because it closely matched the colour of his eyes anyway. And then just used, obviously, a little bit of black for the pupils. I cheated with the eyes. I didn't cheat with them, because the iris and the pupil had indentations in there anyway for those already, so I just followed those. And when I did those, I then just went in with some of the Tamiya clear lacquer and put some of that on his eyeballs just to make them a little bit glossy, and then came back with some really, really watered down red. And just from where the tear ducts are, right round to the corner there, just let that do a little bit of a capillary action to get that looking as good as possible. So that's about it. Underneath these little wound areas as well, I basically used the red that came in the kit. It's this red here. I used that with a little bit of black, and then actually drew the flesh into the wound, or painted the flesh in the wounds there, and then went back over them again with the brown, just to kind of get that kind of mummified look a bit better, really, to be fair. I think it worked, to be honest, because you can see a little tinge of red in there, but he looks more barbecued than anything else, I guess, for those areas. And then we've got the book there. So this was the red that was in the Dungeons and Dragons kit. I just used that. I thought, you know, there's no real one colour by the looks of it in the TV program for the colour of the book. So I just decided to do that in the red colour. And then again, I used the bone white for the book pages, and then I just dry brushed on some gold leaf to try and get the edges of the book looking as though it's one of those really kind of old books. And I think that worked. And then I just used the Tamiya yellow for the writing on the stand. And that's about it, really. You know, I gave him a good coat, actually, of the Tamiya matte clear coat as well over the whole body, just to sort of protect the paint underneath it, because I did notice as I was painting him and moving him about in my hands, you could see where I was holding on to him in some areas, where I was holding on the most, that the paint was coming off. So I thought, well, I think the next time I do a kit, once I've actually got all the flesh tones done, I just then instantly put a lacquer over the top of that to protect the paint. But yeah, not looking too bad. Happy with my first sort of go. Let me just zoom out a little bit. Way too far, and it was the wrong way. But yeah, happy with my first attempt for doing a figure. As I say, whether this was the right figure or not to use as the first go, I don't know. I suppose in some respects, because he's like meant to be dead and mummified, if you kind of screw it up a little bit, I guess it wouldn't really matter too much, because he's already messed up when you look at him. So I don't know. But yeah, I mean, if anybody's got any kind of hints or tips or tricks or whatever you in regards to this kind of thing, please do comment below just to let me know, because I've never done figure painting before, and it's something that I want to actually learn how to do. It's something that I've been putting off for years, just sort of, I'm going to be no good at that, and all that sort of stuff, psyching myself out with doing it, really. But now I've got a 3D printer, it's like, well, cool, we've got to learn, because there's so many things out there that you can do. Hints, tips and tricks, please people in below, as I say, I just need to learn how to do these. But that's about it, guys. I will come back to you in the next episode of I think part 10 of the Daring. It's not that far away. Well, for you, it's not that far away from being built. For me, it's built and sitting on the shelf. And then I just need to, after that, get the videos out for the HMS Kent, which I'm just working on the seascape at the moment. So that will follow pretty soon. So that's going to be about it, folks. Thanks for watching, and as always, please do take care.